In 2008, I recorded an album called the Zenden Suite, which is a jazz quartet with a string quartet. And this album was essentially supposed to be an extension of that in terms of instrumentation. But I thought I could record a demo myself with using two soprano saxophones, alto saxophone and tenor saxophone, sometimes two tenors, in place of the string quartet. I could do all that myself by overdubbing. And anyone who knows me knows that I love to play the bass. So I thought, what better way to get better than to challenge myself for a record date? So as I continued writing for this album, I became obsessed with the idea of this new instrumentation and the idea of doing everything myself. As a challenge and, you know, also as a different sound, it's unlike anything I've ever recorded before. Yeah, I'm very lucky to have Jimmy Macbride on drums. He's one of the most in-demand drummers in New York City at the moment. I book him whenever I can.
I'm really glad that Troy asked me to be part of this project in particular. It was a lot of fun for me, not only because playing with Troy is super easy and feels very comfortable, but the tunes that he wrote, I really felt like it was easy for me to be myself and to inject my own personality on them. The fact that he played every other instrument made for an exciting experience for me. I've never actually done that, just having one person play everything and kind of playing along with pre-recorded tracks.
Dave Darlington mixed and mastered my last few records at his studio, Base Hit Studios in Midtown Manhattan. But this is the first album of mine that he's engineered as well. And because there was only two of us, myself and Jimmy, it was really easy to do the whole record, tracking, mixing and mastering all at Dave's studio.
I think this project is cool because it kind of marries the two bands that Troy has. It has some elements of, you know, his more straight ahead group, and then he's playing electric bass. There's some tunes that are, you know, have involved different grooves, world grooves, and some funk and hip hop kind of stuff. So I think it's kind of a great blend of all of the things that he's put out thus far.
My first compositional rule of thumb is to capture ideas. I made a pact with myself to stop whatever I'm doing at any point. When I have an idea, I'll sing it into my phone. Sometimes they lead absolutely nowhere. So this album is essentially a collection of stuff I heard in my head.